This is CMTV News Cameroon. Government on a hot seat, denies international intervention. Squeezed by the international community over its handling of the crisis in its predominantly English-speaking regions. The government of Cameroon has dedicated this Tuesday to a robust public relations campaign aimed at avoiding external intervention and cleaning its image. Terribly battered by some national and international rights groups. While External Relations Minister begged diplomats to allow President Paul Biya handle the crisis, the Minister of Defense organized a press lunch to fine-tune local and foreign pressmen on the Republican role of the army in strengthening national unity. In a declaration to members of the diplomatic corps and representatives of international organizations, the Minister of External Relations said, "Cameroon is still enjoying stability despite attempts to smear its image. Far from reports that things are falling apart, Lejeune Belembella argues that the country is on stable waters despite the conflict in the northwest and southwest regions. Complying to its national and international engagements, whatever be the case, the situation prevailing in the northwest and southwest regions, no matter how worrisome internally, does not in any way represent a threat to international peace and security," he said. On the damaging reports indexing the military for rights violations, the minister maintained the defense and security forces have remained professional as they battle separatists in the northwest and southwest regions. Though the public is yet to experience this, he said, soldiers found guilty of human rights excesses have been sanctioned. Reports from some human rights organizations are only intended to cause chaos in the country, Lejeune Belembella added. Cameroon's foreign chief told the diplomatic corps that figures depicting 4 million affected victims of the Anglophone crisis are unreal. Basing his argument on 2015 statistics from the Bureau of Census and Population Studies, BUCREP, government's humanitarian plan is in full force, and out of 150,000 IPs identified, half that number have already benefited from the aid. The government official has downplayed accusations that Paul Biya has opted for a military solution to the deepening conflict, stating that the head of state has always privileged dialogue and he will continue. He begged the diplomats to allow Paul Biya to handle the situation, while they encouraged their home governments to cut funding and prosecute those financing the secessionists. In a direct feedback to Maurice Kamto's external sympathizers, the minister says Paul Biya won the 2018 presidential elections with 71.28% and the debate on this issue is over and closed. The minister delegate at the presidency in charge of defense also convened journalists to a press lunch. The convivial conclave was meant to edify them on the pivotal role played by the army in keeping Cameroon one and indivisible. Critics, however, argue that the minister was instead trying to convince the press to turn a blind eye on military atrocities which have been echoed loudly in recent times. Thank you for watching. Make sure to subscribe for more news on this channel. CMTV News, information is never enough.